This is going to be a quick video tutorial to show you how simple it is to start collecting electronic payment for your quote deposits using Mothernode CRM. So get paid faster by making the payment process really convenient for your customer. So what I've done so far is I've connected my Stripe account to receive credit card payments, and I've also connected my Plaid account for my ACH payments if you choose to do that. What I've also done is I've set my credit card threshold to accept payments up to $50,000. I wouldn't normally do that, but for this exercise, I am collecting a large deposit and I want to make sure that I can show both options and explain the difference when we get to that payment screen. All right, so you can see over here that I have a quote over here for $26,000, and what I'd like to do is issue, now that it's been signed off, I want to issue a deposit invoice to begin the work, and I want to receive 50% of the payment and give my customer the opportunity to pay this electronically so we can get going quickly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on my deposit invoices tab in the quote, and I'm going to click on add deposit, and then I'm going to use 50% as the amount that I would like, and I'm going to say get amount, and then it's going to come down to $13,391.86. What I can do is actually display the line items in the deposit invoice, but what I am going to do is just simplify this with a message that says pay this please. All right, I'm going to click save, and now we have our deposit invoice for $13,000. Also, in the quote header, it's applied the deposit required for $13,000, and what that means is that when we print the quote and we send it to the customer, they're already aware of the $13,000 deposit required to begin the work. Now that they've agreed, we're going to send them the deposit invoice for payment. So I'm going to click on print. Now that I have a deposit invoice created, I can click on deposit invoice as an option, and I'm going to send it to them. One thing I recommend is, obviously you have an email that you can send, but it's more efficient if you create your own templates, and I always recommend next steps or instructions. Some things I've highlighted here, so you can see thank you for your business, it references the quote number and the reference on the quote. So in this one we're doing an electronic deposit payments sample. I've put in this information, I've built this from scratch by myself, so you can do something similar. Include, you know, some graphics here that can show the kind of payments that you accept and so on. And then once you're done with this, you can just click send. And then we'll go check the sent files here. We can see that now this has been sent, it's pending, they haven't looked at it yet. Again, as always, if we made a mistake, we can go ahead and expire the link and they won't be able to receive it. I'm going to go over here to my sample email account, and I'm going to click on the deposit invoice email that I just received. Again, the instructions that I have here, everything laid out nicely for me, so I know what to do. And what I have to do as the customer is I'm going to go ahead and click on the link that basically takes me to the deposit invoice itself, and then I'll click pay invoice. So then I'm taken to the payment screen where I can apply my payment. Now the only thing that's different about the deposit invoice payment screen versus the invoice payment screen is that in the deposit invoice I cannot change the amount of the deposit. This is the number that is required to begin the work. If I were sending an invoice for payment, they do have the option to actually apply a partial payment. So if they are going to pay 50%, 25%, whatever that may be of the invoice, they can pay that and it will be applied to the invoice. You'll see that in the next demonstration. So down here, I can download a copy of this deposit invoice. I also want to check the information I have here that's on the account that came over from the quote. And over here, I have the option to pay via credit card or by bank account via ACH. Now, to be clear on this, I have the bank account tab because I have a Plaid account. If you do not have a Plaid account and you did not fill in the Plaid information, this option will not be available to you. If you have a Stripe account, then this credit card tab will appear here as well. The only other reason the credit card tab would not appear here is, as I was saying earlier, is if the amount of the deposit or the invoice exceeds your credit card threshold. So if you're only willing to take credit card payments up to $4,000 or $5,000 per se, then if the invoice is, or the payment required is $10,000, credit card is not an option for you, and that's done so you don't get stuck paying these high credit card fees on very large balances. So first of all, to show you the bank account connection over here, again, if I have a Plaid account, I would want to verify as the customer my bank account. So they would be prompted to do so. They could choose from a list of the banks that they have here, also some other banks as well. I click on Wells Fargo. I'll put in my test information. And assuming that Wells Fargo is the customer's account, once they click Submit, then it will go and fetch their account information, and here they have actually two accounts that they can choose to pay with. Now, unfortunately, the amount that is in these accounts exceeds the amount of the deposit invoice, so neither can be used. I'll select an account first and just click Continue, and I'm not gonna use that, okay? Although the account is connected, I'm not going to use the bank account ACH via Plaid to make that payment. I'm gonna go back over here to Credit Card, and then I'm gonna put in my name and my credit card information. This is a test account provided by Stripe. And now via credit card, I'm gonna click Pay Now. So once I click Pay Now, as the customer, I receive my payment confirmation on screen. It shows how much I paid for the deposit. Of course, it was 50%. And how much is left to pay on that account, which is gonna be, you know, $13,000, assuming that there's no changes along the way. And I have my transaction information, transaction ID, and so on and so forth. And if I'd like, I can download a copy of the actual invoice itself. If I go back to the quote, and I go over here to the quote header, now you can see that the deposit has been received. The payment type was paid by credit card by David Waters, this email address here. And then also the confirmation number is the same Stripe transaction ID that's been applied in your Stripe account. It's also applied over here into the actual confirmation for the quote. So going forward, you can invoice for the balance of this and do the exact same thing, collecting electronic payments on the invoices. And that is how you issue deposit invoices for electronic payment via credit card or ACH in Mothernode CRM.